What's up, guys? It's Ryantium here, and today we are back in Skyrim. That's right, you guys, and no snap, it's gonna be an awesome freaking day. So guys, welcome back to Skyrim! It feels so damn good to be back here in Skyrim. If you guys are wondering why I've been gone for so long, for those of you that don't know, because I'm sure a lot of you already do know, do please check the video in the top right-hand corner to go ahead and see why I've been gone, where the channel is going, and what's coming next, and all that good stuff. So without further ado, let's get back into this. So today we're gonna be taking a look at the Huntsman's Hut. And holy freaking hell, is it gorgeous. Look at that. That is like the realest looking cabin I have ever seen in Skyrim. It's gorgeous. So where exactly do you find this cabin? Well, we're right here. The Huntsman's Hut is located in the Rift right next to Heartwood Mill, across from Falder's Tooth and the Golden Glow Estate. But Riften being the closest hold to you, that's probably where you're going to want to be to go ahead and find it. Now, this home is situated so freaking picturesque. Is picturesquely even a word? It is a pleasure to look at this house. I mean, I feel unworthy just looking at it. It is so fucking pretty. Oh my god, it's beautiful. So, let me stop gushing over the outside of the house and let's actually get into this, shall we? So, it looks like the exterior of the home is just that. It's just the exterior of the home. Not a whole lot going on, with the exception of the grindstone, the anvil, and the workbench being outside. Always nice to have, although it seems there's no smelter. Now, if I'm not mistaken, there's either going to be a smelter inside, or there's going to be one in Riften. I believe there is one in Riften, because there's a quest, I think you... Oh, no, that's for the Forge, never mind. But yes, there is one in Riften. But tanning rack outside here as well. Just a beautifully done cabin. Let's see, what does it look like at noon? What's it look like? Oh, it's got the shadow. It takes away the beautiful, like, contrast of the wood and all that stuff. But the textures are such high resolution. God damn it, I love that so much. So, this home is a free home, and we can go ahead and go inside. But let me just go ahead and show off this door. Hang on, I gotta gush over this door. That is a beautiful wooden door. Now, this home obviously is going to be a very tiny home, probably more so for the person who wants to roleplay with something a little more modest, rather than super extravagant massive castle in the woods or massive castle on the side of the cliff and stuff like that. So this place is definitely for a specific type of person, but I love the inside decor. The static clutter looks incredible. I love the way it looks. We have our bookshelf right here for the bookworms of Skyrim, a little bit of a weapon rack right here to go ahead and store some regular weapons, little knapsack right here. We've got a nice dresser right here, a beautiful looking bed right here. It's very nice. It's very nice, I gotta say. And then we've also got, looks like, ingredient storage, a little bit of an alchemy lab right here. So there are tools here, which is kind of nice to see. We have our cooking pot, and then we have our nice little kitchen over here. Now, we could do this in 2 seconds and say, here's the house, and we're done with it. But that would do a disservice to the mod author, because let's just take a second and admire the beauty of the inside of the home. Now, I'd imagine with that window coming, the light coming in right there, I imagine it changes. Yes, indeed, it does. So with the light changing, it's very, very nice. Adds a little bit more ambiance into, you know, into the home. It makes it feel a lot more alive, especially at around this time. In fact, it might be an hour later. Right there, yes, that's what I like to see. The orange light coming through. Just so pretty. So we have our food storage right there. And we have just so much static decor. Half the shit in this house you can't even touch. It's kind of nice. But we've got nice little storage barrels right here. A couple large sacks. Definitely for the explorer or hunter on the go. If you've ever wanted to just roleplay as kind of like a hunter or, you know, something like that, an explorer, this might just be the home for you. And honestly, if I were to ever do another, you know, playthrough of Skyrim, I would use this home. I would have this home installed like that. It is a beautifully done home. I love it so much. There's really not more I can say about it other than it's just gorgeous. It's perfectly placed in the world. Right next to the water. I mean, look at that. You could sit on your freaking front porch and watch the sun set. It's so beautiful. You could watch the sun rise. It's absolutely gorgeous. So guys, I very much hope that you enjoyed this wonderful little cabin right here. Let me know if you liked it down there in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.